celebrities put through some of the toughest and most grueling trials, from having to eat horrible things to encountering almost every critter Africa has to offer. There's no doubt they've all been tested in the jungle. But sadly, last night on I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here, it was time to say goodbye to the very first celebrity. But we're lucky enough to be chatting to her right now. Please welcome to Studio 10, AJ Rochester.
Yay! Hey, g'day.
AJ, we were so sad to see you leave last night. What was the toughest part about jungle life for you?
Oh, the toughest part is the hunger. You really can't describe it. I mean, people see us getting food at the night, but it's tiny little portion amongst a big group of people, and you're out there doing things and you just got to suck it up and find energy where you don't have it. That, you know, I mean, plain oats and plain rice and plain beans every day. It's rugged.
And AJ, there's a real mix of celebs in the jungle this year. Forgot to invite me. Who surprised you the most and why?
Oh, God. I think, you know, it's funny because when we first met Dermot, he was very quiet and very granddaddy, daddy kind of thing. But then when Shane wandered into the jungle, he was like a 12-year-old let loose on a school trip. And that was really funny to see the footballer side of Dermot, like the one that he keeps very, very guarded, you know, all the antics. You know, he's up under my bed in the last night, like throwing tissues on Shane's head in the middle of the night to freak him out. So I think Dermot was kind of the most pleasant surprise.
You shared some amazing stories in the jungle that we all saw you talk about, including the journey to finding your birth mother. What was that moment like when you realised you already knew her? And do you have advice for anyone adopted looking for their birth family?
Yeah, it was very surreal when I met my mum, and it was like we already knew each other. We'd known each other for a year and a half without even knowing that we were mother and daughter. And, you know, I think the advice that I would give people is, one, just go slowly. You know, to the birth mothers, you know, there's no shame in what you did back then. So please, no matter what's happened since then, open your door and your heart to your kids, because we just want to belong to someone and we want to know where we come from. And get counselling. Please get counselling for both of you. It's just going to make that transition so much easier and you know, bring together a family versus breaking up families, because no adopted kid wants to break up a family. They just want to be part of a family at last.
And AJ, another really emotional point was when you were telling the camp about how you were homeless at one point after the welfare fraud case and the reporting of that in the media. Do you think people underestimate the role of the media?
Oh, you know, I think most importantly, more than anything else these days, is people need to check the facts. Just because it's written online, just because it's written in a newspaper, just because somebody says it on radio, just because somebody says it in passing, doesn't make it real. Get the truth first and then form a decision. And the media needs to be more accountable. No more fake news, people.
As you started the beginning of this jungle journey, Australia was shocked to find out you've been celibate for 9 years. Are you looking for love now that you're out of the jungle?
Oh, my God, I've always been the queen of TMI. Yes, I would like to find love. You know, let's just have a burger first. First things first, let's just get our priorities right, OK?
Yeah, make love to a burger. Now, AJ, you also competed in a trial with Richard Reed where you rode in a helicopter with a crazy pilot. What the?
That was literally very, very terrifying, but I was so determined to fake out Richard and pretend that I wasn't absolutely pooing my pants. And, you know, to see him faint, you know, it might have only been for 3 seconds, but just that was my little victory. I may not have won the putt-putt, and I may be the only person injured in a putt-putt game in the world, but Richard fainted for 3 minutes, so I'm taking that as a win.
Well, before we let you go, we would love to know who you would like to see take out the title of King or Queen of the Jungle.
Well, I want Jackie Lambie, my sister from another mister. I want her to win. But I think Luke is probably going to take another crown, another trophy for his trophy shelf.
Really? Well, we'll have to wait and see. AJ, we've loved watching you in the jungle. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks, AJ.
Well, AJ may be on her way back to Tinseltown, but on-set sources say that another bold Hollywood A-lister is on the next flight out of LAX and headed for South Africa. Who will be the next intruder? Seriously, the suspense is killing it.
Literally, I'm dead right now.
You're dead right now. Tune in to I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here tonight at 7:30 p.m. on 10 and win.